Karan Jekli Live.
Hi guys, welcome to my channel. And today in the weekend cooking, we are going to make Gajar ka Halwa. So some people call it as Gajar ka Halwa, some people call it as Gajrela, some people call it Gajar Pak. So no matter what you call it, it tastes just amazing. So for the full recipe, stay tuned. So guys, to make Gajar ka Halwa, take about 1 kilo of carrots, or in Hindi we call it as Gajar. In Arabic, I learned recently, they call it as Jajar. Wash them and peel them. So guys, after you peel it, you need to grate them. Okay, so this is little hard work, but someone has to do it. So I'm using this grater. In Hindi we call it as kaddukas. Okay, so you need to grate all 1 kg of carrots. So guys, to make gajrela, take about 1 liter of milk. Okay, and pour it in a pan. And to milk, you add all the carrots which we grated. We grated 1 kg of carrots, and this is what they look. So if you look, they look a lot. Okay, so but once it is cooked, you will feel it is less. So add these carrots to the milk. So guys, after you add carrots to the milk, so now you need to cook both of them together. Okay, so keep cooking them. So it will take a lot of time until all the milk starts becoming condensed, right? So you have to cook it with occasional stirring. So guys, now you can see the milk almost disappeared from it. Okay, so now you add some crushed cardamom. Okay, so cardamom is optional, but it gives very good flavor to your gajar ka halwa. So now again, if you see, still there is some milk, it is wet, right? So again you need to cook it until it becomes completely dry. Okay, so it should take another 5 to 7 minutes. Then after that we proceed to the next stage. As you can see, the milk is almost gone from. Now this is the point when you add about 2 tablespoons of desi ghee in it. So guys, I am using Amul ghee. You can use Veer ka or any desi ghee of your choice. So 1 and 2. So now after you add it, so again we need to cook it in the ghee. So guys, and you need to stir it very fast, and you have to keep cooking until the ghee which you added to it separates from it. Okay, so as you can see now, I think, I don't know whether it is visible in the camera or not, you see this ghee is coming and sticking to the pan. Okay, and the other indication that it is cooked is, now the gajrela or the halwa will not stick to the pan. Okay, so you can simply move it away and it will start sticking to each other. So this is the indication that your gajrela is cooked. Now to this we need to add sugar. So guys, I am adding 5 tablespoons of sugar. So you can add more or less according to your taste. Okay, so now I add it. So after you add sugar, again you need to cook it and mix sugar well, because when the sugar melts, again it releases some water. So again we need to cook it for another 2 to 3 minutes. Okay guys, now you can see all the sugar has been dissolved, all the water from the sugar has evaporated. Now your gajrela is ready. Okay, so we'll switch off the heat and we will garnish it with some crushed almonds and cashew nuts. Even that is optional, but they say if you put it, it looks better. So on the top of it, we add them. So guys, this is Gajar ka Halwa. So I hope you enjoyed our recipe. And if you like our videos, please subscribe to my channel and click on the bell icon so that you do not miss any notification. Till then, stay tuned.